Right, in this discussion we are going to deal with Ohm's law. Ohm's law means how we are starting with that each and every parameter. Means for suppose if you take Ohm's law is only applicable for conductors part. Means basically if you take any materials we classify into three categories, that is conductors, semiconductors as well as what insulators. When you deal with conductors, there will be a what, there is no like energy gap in between what valency band as well as what conduction band. So when we apply any external energy, that is when we apply the field, free electrons can easily transfer. So from valency to conduction band, means conduction is easily possible with this conductors part. So when you go with conductors, all the metals comes under what conductors category, right? We can have like gold, silver, aluminium, like different categories we can take for conductors examples. At the same time, when you deal with semiconductors, there will be small energy gap, okay? That is approximately around 1 electron volt to 3 electron volts in between valency band and conduction band in the case of what a semiconductor. So even though you apply the what external energy or the field, there won't be any what charge transfer takes place. There is no flow of electrons. Okay, but when it is possible, when we do with some other materials, then there is a chance of what charge transfer. So that is completely handled by this semiconductor theory, that is semiconductor devices. So where you will be dealing with diode, transistor, such kind of devices. Okay, and when you deal with semiconductor examples, what kind of materials, means silicon, germanium, gallium arsenide, such materials come under that semiconductor category. At the same time, when you deal with insulators part, insulator means energy gap is what more than 3 electron volts. Means there is no conduction possibility in the case of what insulator or insulating material. So you can take examples like paper, some other wood, or best example when you go with insulator, diamond is the best example for that. So why we are discussing about this, especially when it comes to network theory or circuit theory, this is completely valid only for the what conductors category, okay, right? Means how conductors we are making such as circuit elements, resistance, inductor, capacitor, all these are based on conductors part only. The reason why we are focusing on what conductor. So before going with the basic rule, that is Ohm's law in circuit or network theory, we need to deal with some fundamentals with what conductor part. So for that only I am considering conductor. So conductor means it is also material. Material consists of several atoms. Even atom consists of basic particles like electron, proton, neutron. So when we are not applying any external force or energy, so randomly electron, proton, neutron, all of these are present in the what particular conductor or material. So what is our discussion here? Whenever we apply the what external energy, how we apply the what energy in the form of like electric field. Here I am applying the what electric field, right? Electric field is nothing but that depends on the what particular conductor length as well as how much voltage you are giving. Basically electric field means voltage per unit length. For example, if I am considering these are the what two terminals, okay, for this conductor, when I am applying the what voltage here, right, voltage per unit length, that we can call it as what electric field. I am applying the what electric field in what axial direction, okay. I am considering in the form of cable here, that is a conductor. So when the conductor is subjected to an axial electric field, each free electron, okay, right, not all the electrons, only free electrons we are considering. free electrons will undergo, okay, I am indicating these dots with like, for example, free electrons based on that particular material. So free electrons will undergo a force of F is equal to E. E means E is electron charge and E is about electric field. So each and every free electron will undergo with this kind of force, but electron is about negative charge, right? So electron will move in opposite direction to the what field. Suppose if I am indicating these are the what free electrons, so free electrons are moving in what opposite direction to the field. Got the point? So if I am considering these dots with the free electrons are reacting in opposite direction to the field. So free electrons are only moving, all the electrons are not moving in that particular material, only free electrons are moving. So means because of that free electrons only conduction is possible. Got the point? So free electrons are opposite to the what electric field direction. Got the point? That is the way we can have the what the net flow of charge is in the same direction of the electron direction, and the total charge you can indicate with Q is equal to Ne, where N is the what, the number of free electrons crossing a reference cross section area, and E is the what, the electron charge. So each and every electron is having what, the same amount of charge, that is 1.602 into 10 power minus 19 coulombs. But only based on the number of electrons, the total charge is changing. But how we consider, okay, right? When we explained just now, electron direction or the charge is opposite to the what electric field we are saying. But when we go with current we are indicating with I, or even we can call this as intensity of electricity. But current, when we take, okay, it is in the same direction how we are applying the what field or voltage, you can say. Means in general, current is a positive phenomena. Means current direction is opposite to the what electron direction or charge direction we choose. So absolutely there won't be any difficulty when you take the what current direction or charge direction, okay, in opposite to each other, okay, absolutely there is no difficulty or difference in giving the what final result. You can choose current opposite to the what charge or electron direction, or in the same direction of the what charge also, absolutely there is no difference. But now when we go with the current definition, current or intensity of electricity is nothing but rate of flow of charge. Rate is nothing but differentiation. So how we write mathematically, I is equal to dq by dt we are indicating, right? So you can even give another kind of units. So amperes we are giving for current. Another unit based on this relation, what is that? Dq by dt means we can write it as coulombs per second, because charge unit is what, coulombs. So for that current we are giving it as what, coulombs per second or ampere you can give. Now when we just go with current density, means when current is flowing based on your applied field through a cross section area, you can indicate with what current density. Current density is not a different one, right? Current for unit cross section area you can give, that we are indicating with what, J is equal to I by A. So ampere for meter square you can give, that is what current density. Okay, these are the what basic parameters before going with the what Ohm's law statement. Current density, as we explained here, current per unit cross section area, right? When I consider this is the what cross section area, right? So when current we are considering opposite to the what electron direction, this is what a free electron direction opposite to the applied electric field, and current direction we are choosing opposite to the electron direction. Current per unit cross section area we are defining it as what, current density. Here only we are dealing with statement. When it comes to the statement of Ohm's law, what is the statement? Always Ohm's law is applicable only at what constant temperature? Okay, Simon Ohms defined the word Ohm's law first in what field theory format, that is in fields. What is that statement? At constant temperature, current density is proportional to applied electric field. So whatever the field you are applying, for that field, proportional to that, there exists a word, current density. But it is valid only at what constant temperature. Got the point? So when you remove this proportionality, what we get? J is equal to, I'm introducing a proportional constant, that is what, a sigma. Okay, so this is what, current density, electric field, and sigma we are calling it as what, conductivity. And it is a proportional constant. Right? When you just draw that relation, this is similar to Y is equal to MX form. When I am indicating current density and electric field along with X and Y axis, how we get that relation? Okay. So Y is equal to MX means we get a straight line passing through origin. Right? Okay, and when you consider this slope of this straight line passing to origin, we can indicate with what proportional constant, or the word conductivity, right? This is the word basic statement of Ohm's law, which is defined in what, fields only. How to write towards our circuit theory or network theory, how to make it towards circuits? Right, just need to replace the word current density as well as what electric field. Just before we defined, current density is nothing but what, current per unit cross section area. At the same time, when I write electric field, what is electric field? Voltage per unit length we are writing, and units you can give volt per meter. Here units you can give ampere per meter square. Now we are just replacing this current density as well as what, electric field. Current density means I am writing it as I by A. A means cross section area. Conductivity is nothing but reciprocal of resistivity. Means I can replace sigma with what, 1 by rho. Where rho is the what, resistivity of the material. Okay, it depends on the material. So when I indicate 1 by rho, and this is what, electric field, I can write it as voltage per unit length. Now if I am writing relation towards voltage and current, V is equal to, how will write, rho L by A into I. In this form I am writing, and this is the word proportional constant that I am replacing with what, resistance R, right? R is the resistance, or the word proportional constant. So I can write it as voltage proportional to current I. This is for what, circuit theory or network theory. Again, this is also similar to our Y is equal to MX. When I write that voltage current characteristics, VA characteristics, we get a straight line passing through origin. Slope of this line indicates what, resistance or proportional constant, right? So first, Ohm's law defined in field theory, and how we are writing towards the circuit theory. Entire discussion we are going to write relations, voltage current completely depends on this relation only. Means it is valid only when temperature is what, constant. Means throughout the discussion temperature is kept constant, then only there exists a what, linear relation between current and voltage, or current density and what, electric field. Otherwise, there won't be any what? Linear relation between voltage current or current density and what? Electric field. It is completely depends on what? Constant temperature. So we are just following with this, and we use the same relation when we go with what other circuit elements such as resistance or inductor or capacitor. So this is what the basic form. Next we are going to extend this Ohm's law in different forms when we choose what different circuit elements. Now we are going to discuss about limitation of Ohm's law. Before that, when you observe the relation, okay, so voltage and current proportional to each other, but it is possible only when temperature is kept constant. This is the word condition. At the same time, even temperature is constant, is nothing but our limitation of what? Ohm's law. Before that, what we are saying, when temperature is constant, automatically this proportional constant is also a constant, means which is not at all changing, right? Then automatically we can have a what linear relation between what voltage as well as what current. Means it is valid only when temperature is what constant. What we are saying, this is what resistance. On the name of Simon Ohms, we are giving notation, that is what units first when we give. Units for the resistance is what? Ohms. Right? What is resistance? Okay. So, when you consider the word conductor, we even discuss that we will be having electron, proton, that is what based on the free electrons only charge carriers we get, and charge is what coming when we excite with what some external energy, that is in the form of what electric field, right? So when we are following with this kind of notation, okay, current always we select in opposite direction to the what electron direction. This is the what electron direction based on the field representation. This is the what field orientation, right? So electrons are flowing in opposite direction to our current notation, right? So when free electrons are what moving from this point toward here, automatically some stable particles are present. Stable particles means we can have stable electrons, protons, even some other particles in the material, which will oppose the what flow of free electrons. Sometimes there exists a what collision, okay, that we name it as thermal collision. Why we are naming thermal collision? Whenever free electrons are having collision with the what other stable particles, because of that collision, there will be what some loss of energy. That loss of energy is observed in the form of what heat. So you can say that resistance is the what opposition for the flow of free electrons. Okay, because of that thermal collision only, some energy is what lost in this what conductor in the form of what heat. That is the reason why we say that conductor is dissipating some energy in the form of heat. How we indicate this obstruction? We are observing for the what flow of free electrons from here to here. So how we give the what notation symbol for the what resistance, that we are indicating like this. Okay. Suppose if I am applying the word voltage with this polarity, current is flowing from here to here. Same thing, even you can give the word polarity in this manner. When I give this kind of voltage, then current will be flowing from here. What is the observation from here? Just before we mentioned, okay, right, proportionality is there in between what voltage and current. When you notice the what VI characteristics, right? When you notice the VI characteristics, what we get? Straight line passing through origin. Here we have a straight line passing through origin in between what? First quadrant as well as what? This is what? Third quadrant. So if you just go with this two-dimensional plane. So if you notice in first quadrant, both voltage as well as currents are what? Positive. Right? If you choose this third quadrant here, voltage as well as what? Current, both are what? Negative. Suppose if I am choosing this kind of position, here both are positive. Again, if I choose this position, both are negative, but the value will be same. Slope is not changing. If you choose the what position of that device or the what resistance or resistor in first quadrant or what third quadrant, means you can give the what energy or you can get the what current direction in both ways. So absolutely there is no problem for this. From this what you can comment? Basically, if you notice that resistance characteristics, if you see, that is about the linear characteristics because straight line passing through origin. At the same time, right, it is absorbing the what power and dissipating in the form of what heat just before we given this discussion. At the same time, if it is absorbing the what power, it is a what passive element. And again, you can give the what energy in either direction. So you can comment that it is a what bilateral element. So resistor is a what linear, bilateral, and passive device. Okay. Now we already given that units for the resistance is what ohms, and even we mentioned the what definition for the resistance, that is it is the opposition for the flow of what the free electrons. Next thing is as I mentioned, we'll be dealing with what limitation part, limitation of Ohm's law, right? What is the major limitation? That is temperature is what kept constant. Suppose when temperature is not kept constant, what will be the difficulty here? Resistance is what completely depending on what temperature. If temperature changes, automatically resistance changes. We have one basic relation. What is that? RT, which is equal to R into 1 plus alpha into delta T. Observe here, R is the what earlier resistance when there is no temperature change. Alpha is what temperature coefficient that depends on the what particular material. Okay, so based on the right coefficient of the material, means based on the material it is changing. Basically here we are discussing about what conductors. Conductors, if you choose conductors, means all the conductors are having what positive temperature coefficient, right? Semiconductors, if you say semiconductors will have, that is negative temperature coefficient. That story is different. So here we are discussing only related to our conductors part, right? It is completely based on our material. Delta T means that is the temperature variation. Suppose if temperature is varying, automatically alpha is what positive. Because of this, RT is the what new resistance with respect to that what temperature change. Definitely, if temperature increases means automatically resistance increase. But what we mentioned for resistance, when we write the what relation, how we are writing? V is equal to rho L by A into I. This position, okay, resistivity, length, cross section area of that particular conductor, this one we are replacing by the what resistance or what proportional constant. So when I say that resistance is increasing, when I express in terms of these parameters, resistivity of the material, length of that material, A is about cross-section area. If you observe this, suppose when resistance is increasing, definitely length also increases, at the same time cross-section area increases, but one is in numerator, another one is in what denominator. Approximately the variation is what negligible, because one is opposite to each other, means one is in numerator, another one is in what denominator. But which one increases, resistance increases, means definitely resistivity increases. When resistivity increases, we already given basic form of Ohm's law in what field theory. When resistivity increases, what will happen to our conductance? Okay, that is conductivity. Conductivity is what? Reciprocal of resistivity. So automatically resistivity increases means conductivity decreases. When conductivity decreases, automatically there won't be any proportionality in between what voltage and current, means V is not equal to I into R, means even though you are keep on increasing the what your field or applied voltage, but proportionality means there won't be proportional current in that particular device. It is not possible. That is the reason why when you want to use that V is equal to IR, definitely this is our limit. Temperature must be kept at constant. Further, we will be dealing with what voltage, current, power and energy relations. How these are coming for even different elements, we will see. Means coming discussion, we are dealing with what basic circuit elements such as resistance, inductance, what capacitance, how we are making, means how we are writing relations for that.